So you can see it's about to conclude. It finished. Let's take a look at where the data ended up and what it looks like as far as structure. So I pointed to the data folder on the D drive. Inside there, there's a folder called demo. And so you can see here, it made a new folder. That new folder starts with the year, month, and day, the base name that I gave it, and then it has the time down to the second at which this started. Inside this folder, there is one file that is about 10 or 11 megabytes for every Z plane in the image. If we had multiple channels, there would be one of these for every Z plane and channel in the image. If we had tiling, there would be one of these for every channel, Z position, and XY position that we acquired. You can see that the individual files, the way they are named is they start with the time at which the imaging began. They have the base name, then they say Ultra2C00. This is if there were multiple channels, that number will change. And then XYZ table Z00000001, etc. That denotes the Z dimension of this data set. There were 575 images in Z, therefore there are 575 images items in this folder. You can also see if you look closely that the size of the very first one is a little bit bigger. That's because the very first one in the set has the metadata for the entire data set.